What I was exposed to as a child, as I said, deeply influenced my appreciation for the arts. And it's one that I hope to replicate in terms of creating opportunity, equity, and access for young people in our community. Now, we are emerging as a community as an arts hub, an international arts hub. But what we cannot forget is that we shall not become a permanent hub, an iconic hub for the arts, simply by relying on imported talent as well as visiting talent and a visiting audience. So Art Basel is an episodic, important but episodic event. We need to groom the future generation of those who will appreciate and commit themselves and support arts. And I find that creating a systemic initiative called the Cultural Arts Passport, a guarantee for kids in Miami-Dade, that's aligned by age, by grade level, guaranteeing access to young kids to a repertoire, a kaleidoscope of activities. Something like every third grader shall experience the Nutcracker, so early exposure to ballet. Every fifth grader will experience Rock Odyssey, a comedic take on Homer's Odyssey at the Adrian R. Center for the Performing Arts. Kids who have an interest in ballet shall be transported through an initiative called the Ballet Bus, a production on the basis of American history. Kitty Hawk will be a guarantee for seventh graders, sort of a Broadway-type performance. It is that kind of exposure that I envision for our kids. I could detail the types of partnerships we have, from the Rubel Family Foundation collection to the Perez Art Museum, bringing the artists in, partnerships with Alvin Ailey Camp, sometimes bringing the kids to the venue, often bringing the artists to the school. It ought to be an organic, interactive, interchangeable, dynamic dialogue and narrative that we're writing here in Miami specific to this entitlement that every single kid ought to have. Just the partnerships are critically important, but it's also our own investment in arts programs in our schools. So during the recession, when people were axing arts and music programs, foreign language programs, we weren't. We reduced administration a massive percentage by over 60%, and we reinvested back into critical programs. And arts and music programs are essential, indispensable programs. And then we did something else. We actually turned some of the plainest, ugliest schools that we had in our school system into art jewels by inviting urban artists to come in and use the frontage, the walls, as canvas opportunities. And I go to Jose de Diego Middle School, which is now on the must-see tour of Wynwood, and you'll see some of the most exquisite art. You go to Ineda Hartner, you go to Zelda Glazier and Miami Art Studio, you go to some of these schools that previously were not known by anybody and now are celebrated by everybody. It's that transition that arts actually afford.